Hey guys, and welcome back to Snake Pass. My name is Francesca, and today we are leaving Baldur's realm, and we're entering Sog Gee's realm as we take on the Crooked Canal. And I don't know if I'll go for 100% collectibles on this one. Last time it was pretty goddamn stressful, to be honest. So we'll kind of see how it goes as we jump into the level. Did you know Noodle is a vegetarian? I find that hard to believe considering he's a snake. Like, all things told. I feel like that might just be trying to make the situation kind of more friendly for children. Let's have a look behind us. You always gotta look behind you in these games, just in case. Gotta keep an eye out for... coins, basically. Okay. I like how we can swim. Oh my god, we can dive. This is cool. I wonder if I can drown. So we hold X to dive. It doesn't look like I have a breath meter. It looks like I'm pretty golden in that respect. Speaking of which, we should keep an eye out for golden coins. I think you should always just look backwards just in case. Oh, this is nice. I like the water effects they've done. Swim up with A. I don't need to swim up. I'm gonna just live down here from now on. You can call me the Little Mermaid. We're just embracing our life as a sea snake. Oh man, sea snakes are crazy. They have this really cool like paddle-like tip. Ooh, a switch! Oh man, Nintendo are doing so well. I'm guessing it might open the snake door. Oh, I'm in like a cave. One sec. I want to go out and have a little bit more of an explore before I start like messing with switches. I feel like we have to have a good look around, right? Because there was definitely some stuff up here. I think. Yeah, see like that one. We wouldn't want to miss this blue. I'm just having a quick look around. See, there's stuff up there, but I'm guessing we have to do the switch to get up there. Because it doesn't look like there's anything else around here. I think we'll kind of try and be thorough and have a good look for items. And if there's like hard to get items near checkpoints, maybe go for them. The problem is like, you know, obviously if you lose on a checkpoint, then you lose all your progress, which we don't really want to happen. Okay, up we go. This level's definitely much darker than the last one. Which is interesting to say the least. Right, let's see what this switch does. Can I get up here? It would help if I didn't like drop my fat tail everywhere. There we go, we can get up here. Up we go. Oh, nope, 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 nope. Noodle, yeah, fanny. Ugh, up we come. That's such a Scottish thing to say. Oh man, my Scottish is showing. There we go, we'll just grip for now. While we kind of figure out where we want to go. We'll go around this, I think. Oh no, we won't. We'll fall off. We'll fall off and land in the water, which is totally fine. Oh, I really like this game, but I do think you have to get used to the controls every time you, like, have a break. Although they are fairly, like I said, they are fairly intuitive. I think I talk about this all the time. Every time I play this game, I'm like, yeah, the controls are pretty good. Right, let's grip and then reach our head up. Come on, you can do it. There we go. There we go. Okay, we're on this ledge. We'll just do that. That might make my life a little bit easier. Come on, wiggle. Wiggle like you mean it. Come on. Why can I not slither? Oh, I'm gripping. I was holding down the grip button and wondering why I couldn't slither. Okay, how do I pull this lever? Ooh, there's a goodie up there. So we'll have to go get that as well. Right, how do I do this? Let go of that. I guess we just go over it? Okay, yeah, so we just put our weight on it, basically. So if we go round and over, that should probably switch it. Hey, look at that. Oh, and that makes it so that we can actually reach the green thing, so that's cool. Just gonna have a quick look around, like, the edges of this, just in case there's any coins or anything. You really gotta keep your eyes peeled, because sometimes they're in some pretty tricky situations. Anyway, up we go. Up. I don't know, this game is really kind of, like, cathartic, I find. Like, it's challenging, but at the same time, it's very relaxing. Look, like, there's another one of those blue feathers we saw in the last episode. I definitely think those blue feathers are a clue to the bad guy. Because the bad guy appears to be a bird. So I feel like, you know, they're kind of a giveaway. Like, let's just have a quick explore underwater to make sure we didn't miss any coins or anything down here. Around all these kind of rocks. Because sometimes you get, like, hidden tunnels and stuff. So we're just going to have a quick look. No, it doesn't look like there is. So let's go. And we'll just slither our way through this gap. Can I see anything useful here? Oh, camera. Camera, please. Camera, why? Is there anything up? No, there's just... We're underwater. Okay. Hey, look at this infinite breath. I like it. Games with, like, breath timers can be quite stressful. So I feel like the lack of one makes this game a little bit less stressful. Although we're having, now that we've got like water physics, we're having a little bit of a trickier time, I would say, with the camera, to say the least. But we got a checkpoint, so let's go hit that. We haven't seen any coins yet. Okay. What we got here? Can I fall through these holes? I think so. Hey, look at this. What's under here? Is this where I came from? Oh, this must be where I came from. Yeah, this is where I came from. Okay, we don't want to go back in here. Oh, I thought I'd found something, like, secret. And it was not. At least we get to hit the checkpoint again. Okay, I think we should go up here. Oh, no. Get out of there. Gah, Noodle. He just kind of, like, gravitated into the hole. I feel like me and this, like, grating are not going to get on very well. Maybe we can just start climbing now, and then it'll be a little bit easier. Let's just hold grip for now. Oh. I made all this progress for naught. Oh, there's a blue one there. We'll get around this before we grab this blue one. There we go. Yeah, there's definitely something up here. But I'm wondering if this is the way we want to go, because I want to, you know, I want to fully explore. Ooh, a coin. Right, where's that coin? Above. How do I get to that? I must have to climb down from something at the top, I think. That would make the most sense. And there's like some kind of water pipe going onto these drums. Oh, no. Raise your head. There we go. You dumb snake. Oh my gosh, right, okay. So yeah, I guess this is like the rest of the level. So how do I get up onto this platform? Because I feel like there's definitely something going on with these drums, right? That's not going to get me to the top, logically. Unless we climb up this thing and get that gem. Yeah, I think this is a dead end, so let's do that. I realize we just did all this work for nothing, but, you know. That's kind of happens with these games. It's not, like, the pathing is not super obvious. I don't think I can make it across that gap, so let's not do that. Let's go back up here and see what happens. Hey, look at this. Oh, that was a good one. Hey. I definitely recommend switching the control style from normal to easy. The easier controls, I just feel like they feel a bit better, because this way, if you're pointing a direction, you also slither that direction, whereas previously you have like a slither button and like a not slither button, I guess. I realize not slither button is probably the worst explanation you've heard of it. Like, worst description. Let's go up here. Come on. There we go. I just want to see what's up here. This will give us a kind of a better view of the map as well. Okay, it looks like I maybe have to go across and climb up. Rather than just kind of going... Let me have a look. There we go. Okay. How do we get across to this bit? That's what I want to know. Maybe from along there, potentially? Or... I've no idea. Ah, we'll figure it out. Oh, whoa, where am I going? Nobody knows. Right. Well, there's a collectible up here anyway, so we'll grab this one. Cool, so we got half of them now. We got half the blue orbs. And no coins. I know where one coin is, though. Right, I want to make sure we do explore the water properly. I don't want to miss anything. Oh, that was cute. We scared the little crab. Is he going to come back out? Can we knock him in the water? We're going to eat him. Is he going to come out? Maybe it's proximity based rather than movement based. Oh no, he's coming out. Oh no, he thought he was going to come out and then he realized we were right next to him. No fun. Okay, we got a checkpoint. Oh, what is this? We're going to push this ball. Okay, that's definitely some kind of a trigger of some sort. Where's it going? Just Indiana Jones in over here. It's going in there. I wonder... Oh, okay, that's how you get up. Hey, we figured it out. Okay. Alright, let's go over here. Okay, there's a checkpoint here and there's a branch there. You guys realize what that means, right? That means secret. 100% that there's maybe a secret. Is it down? Haha, see, it is down. Okay. We can take a stab at this because we're right by the checkpoint. So, you know, if we fuck it up, it doesn't really matter. We'll climb this. Come on. Up, up we go. Oh, no, 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 no. Noodle plus. Hey, okay. So now we have to try and make it down. So this is where it's going to get interesting. Because we have to make it down and then back up. But I feel like we can probably do this. There we go. Okay, we've made it down. And we got the coin. Okay, so now we just have to go back up. Hey, look at this. Oh, no, 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 no. There we go. Look at that. That is German levels of efficiency. I'm not saying that it's a coincidence that we have the colors of the German flag on our snake. And we are a very efficient slitherer. First try. Okay, what's happening down here? I don't want to miss any of the blue orbs is the thing. Because sometimes they can be in like slightly sneaky positions and I feel like usually they're relatively easy to find. Okay, we've got to go up here. Right, up we go. It's not too bad actually. Going up is relatively okay, I think. Is there anything along there? Going up is relatively easy, she says, like, messing it up. No, 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 no. There we go, we're good. We're good. Up, 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 up. Through this gap. Go on, go. It's when you miss the gaps, it's a little bit stressful, because you can go up, but the aim is a little tricky. There we go, we're up. I think there's something on that ledge. I really think there's something on that ledge. We just hit a checkpoint, so I feel like we're okay to go for it. Like, down here? Or is it just a- no, I think it's actually just a ledge, never mind. No, don't fall off, you Wally. There was nothing here for you to find, and now you're gonna- okay, we're just gonna plummet to our death, guys. We just hit a checkpoint, so it's fine. Be free, Noodle, be free! Like I say, not a big deal, not a big deal. We still have everything we've had up to this point. We just have to go grab this. Which we succeeded in doing. And so let's go around here to the left. We'll grab this orb too, I think. And then we can go up here and have a quick look about what's up here. What is this? Oh dear. Okay, we're gonna take a stab at it, you guys. I feel like we have to, right? Oh, I hate going down. We can always press our grip button though. Let's go under here. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Grip, 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 grip. Go around this, go around this, go around this. Head up, head up. Noodle, head up. Oh my gosh. I told you guys, we are so efficient. Oh no, we're not efficient, we're not efficient, we're not efficient. Oh my god. Oh. Oh. If he could, like, stop, just, like, slow down, slow down. Right, grip, put your head up. Put your head up. Grip onto that, and then up we go. Slow and steady, slow and steady. We can be a tortoise in this situation, not a hare. Okay, this next one is where it's tricky. Because we need to basically go up onto that, right? Oh my god! Oh, I've become a master, you guys. I'm now a professional snack. I am the top snack. The most professional snack in all of the lands. Right, how are we doing for coins? We've gotten in a few. Gotta keep an eye out for these blue orbs as well. I think I missed a few in the water, maybe? Oh, there's one there. We'll go get that one. Or not. Or we could just fall off this thing. The thing is, like, when I'm not afraid of falling, I kind of just, you know, wing it. Like, I kind of feel a bit more brave, I guess. Whoops. So, for example, there, like, I could have taken that more carefully and probably done it the first time. But because there's no risk of death, it's maybe not so bad. Whoop, 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 whoop. Come on. Come on, Noodle, you got this. Go under. I guess we go round. Oh, nope, nope, apparently we're just gonna fall to our death. And by our death, I mean into the water. There we go. We now have a hold on that, which is good. Let's use our grip. Where am I going? Okay, I'm gonna keep going up. There's definitely something up here. There we go. Okay, I think we should probably slow it down a bit just because we're quite far along now. So we'll just take this bit nice and careful. There we go. See what I mean? Oh, there's a switch! Okay, let's do our snecky switch thing. Over here, please. Okay, so that makes this then, I guess, reachable. So we can get the yellow one. Oh, I thought there'd be a coin. I've only got 2 coins. I know where a third one is. Oh, we'll see. Down we go. Whee! That was fun. I'm gonna just hit this checkpoint just in case. I don't think I got a checkpoint after I got that coin. So let's just trigger the checkpoint. You know, for safety's sake. That is definitely something under here. Is there anything else under here while we're here? Okay, that's the way to the portal. And I remember there was a third coin over there, but I haven't seen the fourth coin. Hmm. Or the fifth coin. Okay, we'll just go up here for now. And we'll see what's up here. Come on. Up you go. We'll go around this one, I think. Hey, look at that. But those rocks went up as well, so I'm just wondering what the purpose is of the rocks. And we're missing 3 blues as well. This is where I spot like a coin miles behind. That I somehow missed. Because these rocks seem to have triggered. And there's still this drum situation. Ooh, there's a blue. Sneckless, there we go. Like, there's a situation with the water and the drums. I'm just wondering what you're supposed to do with that. Because I feel like you're supposed to do something. I just haven't quite figured out what, you know? There's another blue. We'll get this one. So, we got all the blues. Nice. So, we only need 2 coins. It's just, this has got this kind of sun logo on it, right? So, it feels like you're maybe supposed to do something? Right, let's continue on for now. We'll continue on for now and we'll see if we can find some more coins towards the end. And then if we can't, we'll maybe double back and have a little bit of an explore. And then with the magical powers of editing, we can figure out what's going on. Right, do we go down here? No, but that's where the drum is and the water. And then there's water in here. So I feel like there must be something I can do in the water to like a switch or something. Doesn't look like it, though. Right, let's go across here for now. Now, if I remember, there is a coin down here. So that's the third one. So let's go for that for now. And this one, you don't really have a risk of falling, because you'll just go back to kind of earlier in the level. Although I would quite like not to fall if it's all the same to everybody. Oh, never mind. Oh, okay, let's try that one again. Okay, time for take 2. Just slow and steady, slow and steady. We got this. Look at that. Told you we got this. Oh, we fell. But it doesn't matter. We got the coin. That's what's important. And in this situation, falling wasn't that big of a deal. So let's go have a look for some more coins and see if we can find them all. We got a checkpoint, so that's us checkpointed with all the coins, which is really good. This level definitely feels a little bit easier than the previous one. Or maybe I've just become, you know, a better snack. Like, maybe previously I wasn't very good at being a snack, and now I'm fantastic. Okay, we're gonna have a look along this way. And if we can't find some coins, then we'll go have a little bit of an explore to see if we can figure out where they are. And then go from there, I suppose. Come on, wiggle like you mean it. Because this is the end of the level. What is this? That's interesting. I guess that was where we came from at the start. I don't want to end the level. I do think I have all three of the... Yeah, I have all three of the things, so I can end the level. But I don't really want to. Okay, my dears, we're going to go have a little bit of an explore, and we're going to see if we can find the last two coins. So, do you remember when I said you should always go backwards at the start of the level? It turns out that is definitely still the case. You should, in fact, always go backwards at the start of a level. Oh god, I'm going to fall to my death. God damn it. At least there was a checkpoint right there. But yeah, so one of the coins is right back at the start. Just turn around, and then you've got it. So we'll grab this one and then we'll find the last coin. I think it's more important to maybe be on the rope. There we go, then we could just... Okay, that didn't work either. I like how this is like probably the easiest one in terms of falling coins to get. It's the easiest one to get and I'm still messing it up. Yeah, see? Easy. Right, okay, let's go have another look and we'll see if we can find this last coin. Look at that fish. That's cool. Okay, guys, so this next one is actually quite tricksy. I'm in that first room where I swam under the gate and pulled the switch at the top. And actually, if you go up this ramp and you see this big hole here, I was like, oh, I could probably fit through there. And look at that. We found the coin. I'm just hoping we can slither back without, like, falling off. We did. Awesome! Right, well, I'm gonna make my way towards the end of the level, and, we'll see what happens. Okay, guys, so that's the level wrapped up. I'm assuming that the, coins work the same way as they did last time, and that I'm just gonna unlock time trial maybe for this level. I'm not sure if last time I unlocked time trial for all the levels, or whether I've only unlocked time trial for, like, a specific level. So I guess we'll find out what's going on with that. I'm not really a big speedrunner, so, you know, I kind of like collecting the collectibles, but I don't know if I'll ever actually play the time trials. So there we go, we got everything, all of the blues, and all five coins. Awesome. I don't know, it didn't say anything. It didn't say anything. Maybe, like, the more completed levels you get, the more things you unlock. I honestly have no idea. Anyway, guys, that has been Crooked Canal, and this has been Snink Pass with all the collectibles. I feel like I need to carry on like this. I've kind of set a precedence now that I'm going to have to kind of keep going. Next time, we'll have Lazy Lagoons. We'll try and find some coins. We'll try and find some blue orbs. And hopefully not fall off the edge too much. I've been Francesca from the Killabits, and if you like this video, you know you can always like the video. And you can see all of our social media on the screen. Beyond that, have a fantastic day. Thanks for watching. And hopefully we'll catch you guys next time. Bye! Yeah.